I That changes today with the opening of the number 7.
Well, back then it was just B&Q, just saying.
St-Hudson Yards Station. It's one that was funded to the tune of $2.5 billion by the administration of Mayor Michael Bloomberg. Here's what MTA Chairman Thomas Prendergast had to say as he welcomed guests.
Today I couldn't be prouder to say the number 7 train extension is open for business. This extension will benefit millions of New Yorkers in so many different ways.
That mile and a half long extension from 42nd Street Times Square to here at 34th Street and 11th Avenue is one that is expected to drive the makeover of the Far West Side, a once seedy neighborhood where residential and commercial buildings are on the rise. Here's what Prendergast had to say about that.
Just like in the 20th century, when the 17th train created neighborhoods like Long Island City, Sunnyside, Jackson Heights, this extension instantly creates an accessible new neighborhood right here in Manhattan.
Officials here will be taking a ceremonial ride to Times Square and then back again right as the station opens for business at 1 o'clock. As you can see behind me, a lot of people have come out for this. Anticipation from rail fans and from residents in this area. We're going to be seeing a lot more of those residents as this neighborhood continues to evolve. For now, that's the very latest from the new 34th Street Hudson Yards Station on Manhattan's Far West Side. I'm Jose Martinez. Let's send it back to you in the studio, Vivian.
Thank you, Jose.
Funded by the city under Mayor Bloomberg.
It is a prime example of transit-oriented development. The city recognized that to get people to live, to work, to play, to dine on the Far West Side, you had to make sure it was no longer far.
A short walk from the new station at 34th Street and 11th Avenue, residential and office towers are rising atop a platform covering a rail yard. The sprawling Hudson Yards development will eventually be home to companies like Coach, L'Oreal, and Time Warner.
In the early days of Hudson Yards, the first comment we'd get from prospective tenants was, well, how do we know the subway's going to be open when we get there? And without the subway, we can't really promise to move our employees.
Across the street from the new station, a big bump in business is also expected at the Javits Center.
The subway allows the facility to be connected to all parts of New York City.
Access to the subway could also reverse the route taken by the majority of visitors to the popular High Line, which last year extended to 34th Street.